Oh, Simon. Now, Simon, I think, came up at the end of my first year. Simon Raven, the celebrated novelist. And I'd never seen anything like it. Because Simon, unlike Christopher, who was gentle, who I met a year later, Simon was far from gentle. And his behaviour was totally untrammelled. I mean, he was Dionysus in person. A little Norman from Letchworth in the lower middle classes had never seen anything like it. The tales of Simon, I mean, his sexual goings-on. Now, I only knew about his goings-on with his own sex. And in fact, what later emerged was, of course, that he was equally happy with the girls, too. And indeed, he got married at one point. But I've always found, curious enough, bisexuality, I've always found difficult to understand. My simple view was you were one thing or the other, and you know, you better make up your mind about it. And it's perfectly clear that there are a fairly substantial number of people who are perfectly happy to swing either way. And Simon was that way. But anyway, in Kings, if needless to say, he was only known for his goings on with his own thing. And it was the. I mean, he used to go with some of the dons. He used to borrow what was called borrow in inverted commas money. So he was always on the touch because he was hard up. And certainly he became friendly with some of the dons in order to be able to make use of their financial contributions and so forth. And, you know, I watched all this with a mixture of fascination and horror, of course. but equally he loosened me up too, very much. He was very beautiful when he was young too. Which I'm afraid that he, of course, drink and sex and indulgence of all kinds, of course, shows its mark on you eventually, where Dorian Gray, after all, is in a novel. He doesn't exist in real life. And I was in a television film right at the end of Simon's life, because we were exactly the same age. He was born in December, I was born in March. And I think what the producer wanted was, you see, this wonderful object lesson of what happens to you if you live life to the full. And then how reasonably well preserved you can stay if only you exercise a little moderation. This nice object lesson was available. The tales of Simon, and Simon certainly fell for Christopher, and there's a very beautiful description of Christopher in one of Simon's novels, and so forth.